Okay, it's the first challenge for the Peter Blucher Memorial Shield here today. And in the first minute of the game, big crashing try for Nigel Borlason, number 8. The score at the moment is 4 points to Barkey, nil to Longreach. The conversion attempt for Bark Alden is going to be taken by Craig Rogers.
What's that, mate?
Kick was successful. You're gonna do it, mate.
And now we have your guest commentators, Big Moose and Big Dave.
Welcome, Moose.
Welcome, Dave, here to the Bark Alden Sports Reserve.
Pleasure to be here, Moose.
And Longreach kick off now. Paulie Walsh picks it up. Head to the middle of the field, fellow goes out of the top with a bad tackle. Whilst he's dropped it, Big Trev's come up with it, but he's called a knock on. Well, poor ball security there by Bark Alden 6.
Yes, Ross.
bit of a shocking scrum there. Billy's nailed him after behind the pack anyway. Big second row goes in dummy half, chopped down, good tackle by Billy Bond. Out of marker, good work. Barney Rubble just overrun that pass a bit and the hooker has to go himself. Gets jammed by Big Trevor. Big Trevor coming out of retirement for this game, big pensioner. Oh, I don't know any of these fellas.
As Longreach push back, he's on. Another big hit from Walshy. Two hits in a row from him. As they swing it wide. Craig Rogers got him. Billy Bond. Craig's hurt himself in the tackle there. They're going to swing it wide again, Longreach. To cut it off. Barney Rubble's got the ball.
Oh, why not?
Shocking kick from Barney Rubble as Cove roughs him up a bit there.
Been doing it all day, sir.
As I got the change over here. Now we've got a penalty. Christie to kick for touch. Nice kick there. Trev takes it in for the tap. Got Eddie Blucher. Gonna ruck it up. Gain of about 10 metres there. Got Big Nigel Ambrin up now. Oh, he's taken very high. He could get 10 for that. He's a big. Nigel's. Don't know what he's doing. No, he's right. I think he better watch his back, that bloke. Nigel's not very heavy at all.
And Christy Blucher finds touch with a pretty good kick there. Takes up just over halfway. Trevor taps it, Eddie Blucher hits it up. Barney Rubble jump for the shoulder charge. No good, you big fat pudding. Billy Bond out to Shraggy playing at his beloved 5-8 spot.
Almost made a meal of it.
Quick play of the ball, gets away. Scotty Cowan hitting it up the middle. Oh, and he's picked up and driven in a good tackle. Big, I don't know who that is. Big Craig hits it up, turns, gets a back flop, as it's called in Sydney, to Nigel Borlason, and he just runs over top of Barney Rubble there. Trevor Hay was telling him to get up and play it. Billy Bond calls for it. He'll put the grubber through. Sort of half grubber, half kick. Oh, he. Big Billy's just coming for a big crunching tackle. And big rampaging Philip Thompson on the wing. Scoot out dummy half. Philip Thompson makes the tackle. Good work. That's three in a row for Philip Thompson. Good work.
Very unusual for a winger, that move.
Yes, Dave. Very unusual. Scotty Cowan goes low, Big Craig over top, and Nigel Borson's down in back play. Looks like he's been winded. I think your number 8 jersey's pretty safe there, Dave. Nigel's too much of a sook to bother you. Anyway, Ian Coveney's run, so he's dropped it. And the longest player's knocked it back. No? Guess he reckons he's knocked it on. Well, that was a rough call there.
Very tough call indeed, Ross. Nigel want to get back up and play if he wants me jersey. He's not going to get it back from laying on the ground. He packs the scrum. Long reach feed. Long reach win, naturally enough. Nah, going to have it again. Reckon there's too much in the second row. He didn't put it behind the lock foot, that's what he's shitty about. There we go. Typical second row feed, and it swung out wide. Shraggy takes him a nice tackle around the legs. Good work from Scotty Cowan, breaking that scrum early. And they go wide. Oh, good hit from Walshy. There's Shraggy underneath. Going on the short blind. Plenty of defenders there, but no way through there. Big Trev, yeah. They're going for the fifth and last. Long reach swing it. Got the numbers out here. What'll he do? Oh, and he's made an absolute meal of it. He had the try scored before he caught it.
They call him Butcher.
Jesus. What a tragedy there for the poor long reach fullback. Yeah, well and truly stuffed that one. Looked like a bit of a goose, wouldn't you reckon, Moose?
Yep, bit of a drip. Anyway, Billy Bond gets a feed. Puts it in the second row. Good feed, Billy. Coveney comes in from fullback. Hits it up. Oh, he's beaten the first two tackles. Crawling along the ground. Philip Thompson, dummy half, gets it out to Shaggy. Oh, he's been doing it all day, guess he. Good call. Yeah, get him back at five. Right in the middle of the field. Hi, Jace. Oh, what a kick. He's gained about all the 5 metres. But geez, getting kicked sideways, this fella. And Trevor Hayward, about to tab it, if he can get hold of it. Yeah, right there, Trev. Yeah, whilst he hits it up. Oh, good run, and he's put him in, isn't he? No, he hasn't. Yes, he has. He's hurt him. Good work, whilst he. Eddie Blucher hits it up. Steps Barney Rubble, pointless. Brought down by the big prop with the big melon protector.
Well, Barney must know the coach, does he? He's not playing real
well. must be doing a day bit off going with the coach's tour.
Yeah, good one, Ross, you wank. Hey, guys, okay, why Craig Rogers puts a kick in. Plenty of chase there from Christy Blucher. Oh, that's young Martin Bennett. He might go in. No. Quick play the ball, Craig Rogers from dummy half. Going to look for an offload. No, he's dropped it. Oh, long reach clean up. Through, is it Barney? No, Barney's out in the backs again. As per usual. Good mark of defence there from Christy Blucher. Keep working there. There you go, Watt. Steps inside. Oh, a good hit from Craig Rogers. Walshy over the top. Big Trev, was it? I think Trev might have hurt himself early. Slow to his hit. They put the downtown. Ian Coveney well and truly got it. Oh, no, got past him. Yeah, righty. He'll beat 3 or 4 tackles here, I reckon, Moose. What do you reckon? Here we go. Let's go. There's one. Oh, no, I know he didn't. Sluggish there. Shragging into dummy half. Got Scotty Cowan around for a big run. Oh, he's going wide. He'll go all up. No. A good run. Oh, steps inside. Wee's back up with Martin Bennon. He's going to go all the way under the post.
Great try.
What a try. He's good work from Scotty Cowan there. Ran wide, sucked the defenders in, went round. Under the post, Martin Bennon. Should be an easy conversion for Craig Rogers. Maybe not for Martin Crowe, but Craig might be able to do the job. The crowd, it's a fair crowd here, but should pick up for the Agro game, Ross. What do you think?
Yeah, I think it would, Dave.
Thanks, Ross, for them comments. And I'd like to thank our sponsors here today. I'll just read my shirt and see who we got. Heritage Cordials.
Big Daryl.
Big Daryl from the Foursquare. And we've got
Eric and Narelle
from service station.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, yes.
Sorry.
Oh, yeah, and the Globe and the Union.
And the Globe and the Union, our major sponsors, naturally, of course. Can't forget them. Bert wants to back us for 1,000. Got no takers here, but. Yeah.
If Crowley was kicking this, I think Bert would be a safe bet, but. But seeing it's Big Craig, we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Well, wasn't a very confident kick, that was the word, confident. But it went over. 2 points. And Buffy lead. Buffy lead. 12-0. Hang on, mate.
Quick news to hand, Australia, New Zealand, 14-0 on the test.
And back here live with the action. We'll forget about that inferior test. Ian Coveney's made a meal of it and he's in goal. Eddie Butcher, he's made even worse a meal of it. And it's going to be a line dropout. Well, Barkey Falls has gone to sleep. Well, the crowd's up Nigel Ballison here. I think it's unwarranted. Big Nigel's having a good game. Christy Bleacher drops out. Good drop out. Yeah, well, what a goose. Oh, his mate's not even much better. Good chase from Philip Thompson. Oh, he's gone around the shoulder, sir. Yeah, good call. Yes. Oh, good work by Philip Thompson. Nailed him again. Oh, mate, that halfback, I tell you.
Had a Captain Cook, I reckon, Ross.
Yeah.
Oh, Barney's chasing. No, Barney's out of steam. Oh, Shraggy's been sandwiched in a pretty good tackle there from front rower and centre or something there. Balshy round the blind, steaming onto it. Ooh, met with a wall of long-range defenders. Scotty Cowan onto it again. Oh, big shoulder charge. Here comes Craig Rogers to take a few defenders with him. Oh, offloads to Barney Rubble. Geez, cardinal sin, you don't give the ball to Barney Rubble. God. How do you feel, Craig? Oh, big hit. Trevor's got himself involved in there. Long reach swing out the halfback to the front rower there. Gone. Oh, Nigel's come over and hit him pretty hard. Not bit of stepping and weaving there, more steps in Parliament House, Ross,
yeah,
from young Martin Bennett.
Yep.
We've got Shraggy calling out to the right here. Got Walshy running off him. Beaming on it. Oh, met by big Barney Rubble shoulder charge. But cleaned up by Longreach. Shraggy in there for the tackle. Dummy half, he caught by the marker. Good work there from young Philip Thompson again. Playing real well today. Front right off the halfback. Oh, and he's hit pretty hard. Oh, Nigel fell on him, I could say that. Wouldn't call it a tackle, it was a four. Well, that was well telegraphed. There we go. Back to the kicker, the downtown. Not much pressure from Barkey there. Young Ian Coveney comes back to collect it. Well, it's going to go out, is it? No, he's going to have to run it out, but he'll get around this bloke. What'd I tell you? No, he didn't. Oh, not many Barkey players there to help him. So, Shorty Haywood takes her up for a quick run down the blind side. Oh, we've just been graced with the presence of Liam Ballison, our star halfback in A-grade. Liam Langer, they're calling him. As Eddie Blucher takes her up, draws in three or four defenders there. Shraggy's called for it at the right. Got Scotty Cowan there, going to straighten her up. That's about the fourth tackle. One more than they want to downtown it. Well, they're going to downtown it now. Yeah, nice torpedo kick. Maxie Goodger would be proud of that one. Philip Thompson there to defend. Oh, how stupid that fullback ran straight at him. Team of stupid players, isn't there, Moose?
He's got 75 yards to run in, and he picks the only pole to run in. Good run, mate. Yeah,
real smart. As long as take. Oh, Billy Bond there. Plenty of Barkey defenders there. Billy getting involved there. Philip Thompson too. In a row. And Trev's put the pressure on. Oh, big Barney's come out of the top. Jesus, Barney, you can't do that. Goes left to Scotty Cowan. Straightens the attack. The number's out wide.
Shraggy gets it out to Eddie Bluter. Bit of a step. He's brought down just over the, just on the quarter line. His own side of the quarter line. Nigel Borson takes it up. Well, oh, he's coughed it up. He's picked it up as well. Well, he said play on. Well, good call, Geshi. They put on a Balmain. Scotty Cowan's made a meal, but will he let him play on this time? No, he said pull it up. Well, Nigel Borson, he's as slow as a sheep. And Craig Rogers, he's the rest of the flock.
No,
they're a bit off in the pre-stage. Nah. Hey, Bert, is that Dash for cash? What do you reckon, Dave, you're going in that Dash for cash?
Yeah, mate, it was between me and Kero, but Kero's didn't want to risk any injury, mate, so I think I'll do it.
Oh, rightio, okay.
I feel I have the necessary speed and pace.
Good tackle by Paulie Welsh there. Halfback for the longest gets out. Big Barney Rubble charging on it out wide. Billy Bond goes low. And big Nigel over the top. Oh, what a run. What a run. Longest play back, little halfback's got these forwards running off him all right now. Gets it out of the big prop. Oh, he's copped up. Billy can't pick it up. Martin Bannon. Wow. He's just stood him up. Beat one. Run the crossfield now. Can he link up? Beat two. He does link up. Oh, good ball. Plano gets it out to Shorty Reuter. Shorty Reuter down the sideline. Look at him go. Well, if he goes all the way, he'll get one tonight. No, he won't. Well, if he lasts the game, it'll be sensational. Well, you can't do that to Shorty, and Shorty's going to pug him too.
Shorty, bit of confidence up that fiery game
in
Alpha.
Yeah, that game in Alpha, he landed a lucky hit on some poor bloke.
Considered he's on a bit of a blue these days, I think.
Yep. Thinks he could go a few rounds. Anyway, Alpha come up with it with a penalty on their quarter line. Take the kick for touch. Not a bad kick either. Very good kick.
Call from Dave Kerrigan. Would like to come up for a call.
Big Kero's coming up well. And here we go, Longridge. And here comes big Daryl Kerrigan. Oh, good tackle from Craig Rogers. This goose has just run down the blind side off a tap and gone over the try line, over the sideline.
You pull out with a hamstring.
I've got a slight hamstring tear. I don't want to jeopardise the injury for the game today. It was a bad knock on by COVID. Barkey's a little bit asleep here. I'll get the act together.
Thank you very much, Dave. And now to Dave.
Comments from the Supercoach. All you want to say that. Christy Bleacher wraps him up. Well done there from Christy. As they swing it wide. Oh, mate. Well, straight into him. Good work. You bloody idiot. Yeah, they come straight in the short blind. Oh, he could. Billy Bond's there in cover. There's Paulie Walsh. Great defence. This will be the big test here. Oh, the dummy half, what a typical winger, went himself. Billy Bond's done real well there. Eddie Blucher up, quick up. Put him off with my... Oh, that was almost border on forward. Oh, Christy Nelly for the intercept. Billy Bond might be hurt down here after those three magnificent tackles. No, he's up. Would have been a good try there.
Yeah, it's good work by Billy Bond. We have to give him credit where credit's due, like they say. Yep. Made three good tackles in a row there. Put pressure on the dummy half, made him throw a few silly balls. Barney Rubble breaks out of the scrum. Barney Rubble put on a blue eight, and he's been nailed by Flano. The shift it wide here. Good hit. Christy Bluch has come over the top and cleaned him up. They're just running like a bunch of old women, these fellas. Blues has got him again. Good work, Christy.
What's that step there, mate? Just be careful you don't fall down the steps.
Oh, you think he's hurt him? He's gone.
Yeah. Yeah. Christy's come off worse for wear, too. He's got a crooked chest. Well, they all want the ball here. This fella's just got to pick his runners. They're just... Nobody's coming for it. Yeah.
good work to push him in the ground for Barkey. They swing it wide, halfback, wow.
Like they had a Captain Cook then move for
him. Yeah, he had a bit of a bay peep. The pressure from Barkey was pretty good. Yeah, big Nige, yes. Well, look at him go, he's got that limp going. Here he goes. He gives it to Shorty Hayward, they won't catch him. Well, they won't catch him anyway. Kovo down the side, Shorty's got in his road, but he's still going to go all the way. Under the post, good work from Nigel Borson. Saw they were short on the blind. And the big fella might have a bit of pressure on you, Dave, for that jersey.
No, he doesn't faze me, big Nigel. And no, so he got in the gap there, but he didn't know what to do. He was, he thought he'd throw, didn't think he'd have the legs to go on with it, which I don't think he would have. Oh, hang on, what's happened here? Oh, no, Coveney's dropped it. Nigel will pound shit out of him for that. Jesus, God, that's just inexcusable. Cove, I'm sorry, mate. Mate, you want to get back on the side. He's not hurt, he's just embarrassed. Oh, big... Nigel's absolutely stuffed from that run.
Bark all in a bit at sixes and sevens here. Most of the side thought, as we did, that he'd scored the try. Longridge on their tack. Good tackle there by Philip Thompson. Barkey just got to settle down and get back into their line of defence, I feel. It was a goose doing the step. Longridge put a kick through. Not a bad looking kick either. Fine touch. About 10 metres out from Barkhorn line. I just got to duck down the stairs for a nervous one. I'll put you back on the base.
Okay. Thank you, Dave, for those in-depth comments. And here we are, Barkhorn about to feed the scrum 10 yards out from their own line. Well, Lawrence have got the feed. I don't know how they means that. This Barney, he doesn't mind this blue eight move, broken out of the scrum. I don't see how Barkhorn lost the feed then, because Longridge kicked the bloody thing over the line.
Barney cut the damage in
another. Yeah, Barney just sprints out of the base of the scrum. 5-8 gets it now. Oh, Paulie Wallace falls off him. Good tackle from Scotty Cowan. Pulls him down just inside the line. Quick play of the ball. Halfback goes himself. He's over. What a try.
Totally inexcusable letting the halfback score from that position. He should have been smashed. As a Barkey, 13 left to regather. Get the talk going. Doesn't seem to be a lot of talk there at the moment. They'll have to regroup the Barkey side and get back into it. They've slackened off a bit now. They want to get back, put the pressure back on Longreach. Keep that lead they got. Our boys are sucking in plenty of water, especially Nigel Borderson. I'd like to welcome Super Cameraman in today, Phil.
Phil Payne, doing a wonderful job.
Superb. We just got to keep him off the piss so he keeps the camera straight now. He got the shakes already. Pressure's on him too. If he doesn't have a good game on that camera, he'd get the axe. As this I got a dog. There. This tall streak of duck shit for Longreach lines his kick up. I'll back him in, I suppose. What do you reckon, Ross?
No chance, mate. No chance.
Do you own that dog, Ross?
No.
Oh, suck shit, mate. He's missed that from almost right in front.
Suck shit, mate. That's $5 you owe me.
Oh, damn. That dog, I wonder who owns him. He seems pretty happy there. I think he's going to cut a slash there, Moose. I'll bet you $5 he does. Anyway, back to the action, away from the dog. Barkey while up. Christy's going to place the ball for that kickoff. The dog's following up in cover. Want a deep kick here from Christy, I'd say. Pin him in their own 22. Oh, yeah, very deep. Looking for the chasers now. Take a nail him down there. Eddie Blue, Phil Thompson up there again. Phil Thompson. Yeah, good tackle from Eddie Blues around the leg. Over the top from Paulie Walsh. Dummy half gaze himself. Phil Thompson around the leg with Craig Rogers in over the top. The dummy half. Out to Big Barney. Big Barney, oh, he's been met with a wall of defenders there. Big Nigel in there.
All just going in for a cheap shot.
I wanted to get a flog on him. comes wide at the other front row. Oh, he's smashed. Christy Blucher with a great ball and all tackle. Yeah, Ward 4-1, mate. Oh, the dummy half made a meal of it there. He threw the ball. Christy Blucher's dived on it. Good work. Oh, he's gone down hurt. Shraggy quick. Tries to make a few yards from dummy half. Trevin at dummy half. Christy Blucher onto Billy Bond. Oh, they're going wide. Had no runner. Cleaned up by Phil Thompson. He's taken off. He stepped around him. Met by a few long reach defenders. Big Trevin at dummy half. Picks up Eddie Blucher. Eddie's charged onto it. Offloads to Paulie Walsh. He goes wide. Didn't have the legs, but Big Barney in there with a cheap tackle there. Someone needs to flog him and flog him good. Big Trev to Billy Bond. Shraggy steps inside. Steps. Oh, almost offloads and great tackle. Quick play the ball. Go to the left. Shraggy. No, Christy Blucher, sorry. And we've just been... Eddie Blue from dummy half. Gone himself. He's over.
What a try.
Nothing short of sensational, Moose.
Great stuff there, mate.
Tony.
Yeah, mate.
Thanks a lot, mate. That's great. Very constructive there. Bashford. As Big Craig lines up the kick, what are you going to back him in or out, Ross?
I'll back him in, mate, because double or nothing. You already owe me 5, you goose.
I'll back him out.
A bit of a player profile here on Nigel Borlison in the bottom of our screen at the moment. He's been around for a while, Nigel. Dedicated his life to fitness like Wayne Pearce. Got a melon as hard as a rock. Not afraid to shirk the work.
I think he's getting very old and injury prone, you know. He's just hasn't got the fitness level that Dave Bidoff has in A grade. Ambering around there, he should be pretty fit because he has a pretty hard job, but the railway's there.
Hey, mate, that's 10 bucks,
piss off. 18-4 to Barkey. They want to rack a few more tries up before half time. I don't know how long to go because the clock stopped, as per usual. Hang on, we'll just check on some time.
How long to go?
How long? 11 minutes to go, we've just been informed by our super cameraman.
11 minutes? Shit.
Deep kick. No, Ross, I want to keep talking. Oh, sorry, Phil Thompson's head. That's going to go out. Oh, no. That's twice in a row now, Ross. I'll say it again. Totally inexcusable.
Mate, you say that one more time, I'm going to go into you. Like a loose propeller. Well... Silly mistakes here from Barkhold, and they get the jump on them, and then they just give them another shot. Christy Blucher is about to take the drop out of here. Barkhold have got to pull their finger out in defence. Barney Rubble, well, look at him go. How are we going? Here he comes, charging at Walsh. Oh, what a hit! Good hit. Good hit from Paulie Walsh. He has absolutely smashed him. Good work. Yes, I think Walsh could be on the end of a few short ones up the ribs if he doesn't watch himself. Flano beats the first two tackles. It's called held though. He's got to play it. Trevor Hayward telling him to get up and play it. Here comes Eddie Blue, steaming onto it. Throw a bit of a step in here. Through he goes. Oh, beat the first bloke. Where's his support? He's got no runners and he's coughed it up anyway. Probably was, mate. They do it all the time. Nigel's going to run him down. God help him when he gets out of him, man. He's giving one another tackle, too. Philip Thompson's having a good game out of marker in his defence. His mate racked up a few tackles. Craig goes low, cuts him down. Walshy and Big Trev finish off the job. Quick play the ball out of the halfback. Wide ball, the 5-8. Oh, he's had a bow peep. And Christie's just finished him off. In no uncertain terms. 5-8 now. Is it? No, centre, sorry.
Not
moving up both sides of the ruck. He picked the gap in behind to play the ball and headed for it. Whilst he's down, he's just slow to get to his feet. Big prop runs it up. They're not moving up, Barkhold. They've got to go forward or else these fellas are going to run over them all day. Sixes and sevens, that's a cheap call, mate. Well, it's a handover. It must have been last tackle. Thank you, Dave. And Coveney scoots out dummy half, heads to the middle of the field. Doesn't really gain any ground there. They need their pigs going forward here, Barkey. Scotty Cowan, you always rely on him to straighten it up for you. Good run. They're short on the blind side here. If they head to Barney, well, they've gone the other way. Big Craig, he's made a few yards. Offloads a good ball to Shorty Reuter. Shorty Hayward down the middle of the field, heading for the corner. He'll outpace his fullback, will he? No, oh, what a tackle. Good tackle, mate. And Shorty's been brought down about 10 yards out from the longest try line. Quick play of the ball. They need to ping it straight back. Shorty, you can't pug, mate. Well, he's given him a penalty. Billy will take a quick tap. $10 he gave himself.
Yeah,
oh, that's $20 you owe me, mate. He's come up with a try. That's $20. Dave bit off Ozzy.
I'll have to get this commentator away. I can't afford it. I'll have no match payment left soon. As Billy Bond goes himself again, throws the ball to Craig Rogers for the kick of goal. Good run there from Craig Rogers. An offload to Shorty Reuter. Shorty just didn't have the legs to go on with it. Milk the penalty in no uncertain terms.
Yep.
But you get that. We've got an ex-Barkey player. You might get a comment from him. Phil Edgerton.
Favourite knocker.
Here he is. A few comments, mate.
The boys up here won't buy doubles.
A bit tight, you reckon, Phil?
Oh, very tight. They hand their money around like they hand the ball around.
Any comments for the A-grade game today, Phil?
Oh, well, I think they should do well, the boys here. They're looking pretty fit. Had a few upsets. They drink a bit of grog, but I think they're right there today. They'll be running well.
Thanks a lot, mate. I don't know, I never carry money on me. So Phil's trying to flog some doubles off. He's not having much luck. Thanks, mate. No worries. Craig lines it up. Oh, sort of a pretty chonky kick there, Bashy. Yeah, very chonky indeed.
Okay, referee Gesh out there to get ready for the restart. Long edge kick off. Ball comes down to Paul Walsh, rucking the ball up strongly. Taking a nice tackle there by three of the long edge players. Hayward in a dummy half. Unloads to Shrag. Shrag gets it out to Bannon. Bannon runs strongly down the other side of the field. Hayward in a dummy half again. Unloads out to Scotty Cowan it is. Tackle two. Paul Walsh gets the ball back to Billy Bond. Billy Bond gets it to Christy Blucher, who puts in the clearing kick. Well downfield. Well into Longridge side of halfway. Longridge player comes up with the ball right down near his own try line. Oh, a great chase by Eddie Blucher it was. Come in to take him. Good kick and chase game by the Barkey players there. Eddie Blucher in for another nice tackle. Good work. Billy Bond it is this time, going out the blind side, making the tackle. With Nigel Borlis and Trevor Hayward. Big strong run by the Longreach player there. Okay, it's Longreach putting in the clearing kick now. Ball comes down. Phil Thompson takes it nicely there, never took his eyes off the ball. Had a bit of pressure from the Longreach players too there. They're up quicker for that bomb. Paul Walsh with the ball, decides to ruck it out himself. Met in a strong tackle there with the longest defence. Back with me, says Geshi. That's your line. Out they go, out the back line. No, it's not the back line, it's still the forwards run with a strong run there by Scott Cowan. He's been playing a big game today, Scotty Cowan. Trevor Hayward it is. Unloads Nigel Borlison going wide, looking to unload. Paul Walsh in support. Walsh still going forward, looking to unload, but he decides he's going to hold it. Phil Thompson was there to take the ball, but he was unable to get his hands clear. I know the boys having a bit of a push and shove here. Trevor Hayward it is, unloads to Billy Bond. Big pass out to Nathan Shragg. Throws the dummy, cuts back inside the longest defence. Will he make the try here? Oh, great palm off, yes, and Nathan Shragg it is. Straight under the post for Barkhorn. A lovely try. All started by quick hands by the Bark Alden back line there. Billy Bond unloaded a big pass out to Nathan Tragg. He was looking to unload outside, but through the dummy, the Longridge fellas fell for it. He stepped back inside, palmed off the Longridge cover defender and was quick enough to get around the fullback and go in underneath the sticks for Bark Alden. Craig Rogers it is, taking the conversion for Bark Alden. Successful conversion for Rogers. Longridge with the restart. Put the ball up high and deep. Paul Walsh it is, rucking it back for Bark Alden. Held up in the tackle. Haywood unloads to Scott Cowan, running hard down the far side of the field. Oh, like he had the ball jarred out of his hands there. Knocked on, says the referee, we'll pack a scrum. Well, Scotty Cowan looked like he was trying to unload a flick pass there, but it just didn't come off. Longwich defenders were up on him quickly and jarred the ball out of his hands. Longwich with the feed. Should get the ball here. Comes out Longwich way. Now unload it quick out their back line. They've got their numbers set out wide here, Longwich, if they can unload quick enough, but the Barkey defence is quick up on him. Cuts off the move. Back the other way they go. Big ruck from the forwards. Oh, well lifted there by Shrag. Oh, scrappy play by Longridge. Play on, says the referee. It went back. Oh, well, I thought that might have gone forward, but he's in a better position than I am. Longridge players take it down the blind side, the big front row forward, rucking it strongly, trying to burrow his way through that line. Looking to set themselves out the back line again, Longridge, but the Barkey players are up. Christy Blucher up and jarred the ball out of the Longridge players' hands. What's the referee going to signal here? No, he said it wasn't touched by any of the Barkey players. Martin Bennett is in a strong tackle there. Trevor Haywood. He holds. The big fella wants to go on with it here. Guess he's pulled him out for something. Pointing him, pointing the finger. Awards the penalty to Longridge. I'm not sure what was going on there. I think he might have been sticking his elbow up into that Longridge player, maybe. Ooh, that was very lucky to get over the line, that kick too. Longridge now got the ball 20 metres out from the Bark Alden line. Let's see what they can do with it. Take the tap. Eddie Blucher is in for the tackle with Scott Cowan. Unloads back inside. They're working a move here, Longridge, but they are a great tackle in there from Eddie Blucher. It was. He knocked the Longridge player clean off his balance. Billy Bond standing out wide. Takes the front rower. Paulie Walsh over the top. Good strong tackle. Out they go at the back line. Christy Boucher hanging out there in cover defence. Ian Cove, and he tries to get across, but the Longridge players have skirted around the Bark Alden defence. They worked the ball quickly out their back line and found the gap way out wide. They had a bit of an overlap. Bark Alden coming back for the restart, the conversion being unsuccessful. Big deep kick from Christy Blucher. Longish player takes it from his own end goal, rocks it upfield. Oh, hitting a solid wall of defence there, but he's still carrying the Barkey players forward. And oh, and there the ball stripped free. All the referees call them stripping the ball out there. Penalty will go to Longridge. Let's see what they can do with it here. Under a bit of pressure there, Longridge. Clearing kick comes in. Find the line just on the halfway. Set themselves for a set play here. The Longridge winger comes in and rucks it up, hitting the big tackle there. Oh, he skirts around Craig Rogers, but they lift him again. Nigel Ballison it was coming to clean up. At the back line it goes through the Longridge halfback. He steps, turns around, no support with him, finds a gap there. He's looking for support. He unloads a high pass out to his centre there. Replacement centre, that is. He's taken in the middle of the cricket pitch. By Nathan Shragg. Out the back line it goes. Oh, there's a big fella standing out wide. He must have been having a bludge out there, that big fella. Made a few good yards from there, just the same. Longridge player losing his footing there. Chip kick comes in from the Longridge players, but oh no, it was deliberately kicked at the line. It's fifth and last, it's the referee had signaled, so there'll be a scrum pack down 20 metres out from the Bark Alden line, and Barky will have the feet. Billy Bond defeated. Ball comes out Bark Alden's way. Unloads to Nathan Tragg. Tragg gets it out to Christy Blucher. Big long cut out past to Martin Bennett. He steps around, comes back inside. Looking to unload, but he's taken there. Nice tackle by the Longridge player. It's up, plays the ball. Tragg in a dummy half. Unloads to Walsh, running around strongly. 30 metres out for their own line, Bark Alden. Trevor Haywood in a dummy half. Unloads to Scotty Cowan, taken in the middle of the cricket pitch. Haywood it is. Unloads the ball out to Billy Bond. Billy Bond decides to run himself. Going strongly with the ball. Billy Bond's found a couple of gaps here. Is he going to make it all the way himself? He's looking for his support. He's running towards him. He was taken out 10 metres short of the line. Michael Aylett it is on the field now. He's come on to replace one of the Barkey forwards. Aylett's in the dummy half. Oh, hit late. Well, he's on the ground there by one of the Longridge players, but no doubt he'll square up later on. Out it comes to Rogers, looking to barge his way through the line. Longridge get the ball now, the handover. Take it up hard, hitting a nice tackle there by Paul Walsh, is it on the ground. At the back line it goes. Billy Bond it is in the tackle. Longridge rucked the ball up, hitting a nice tackle there by Michael Aylett.
Welcome back to the Barkey Showgrounds. We're sorry about the interruption to the transmission, but at the moment the score is 38 points to 8. The conversion's been kicked by Christy Blucher. So the score is now 40 points. 34 points to 8. Sorry, the score.
Davey, how much time to go on this game, mate? 20 minutes?
We've got about 20 minutes left in this game.
Thank you.
ball comes out through Craig Rogers. Unloads to Quacker Aylett. Quacker's crashing for the line. Held up about a metre short. Bark all of them set themselves down the blind. They've got an overlap here. The backs are calling out, but they're going to go the open side. Had about a four-man overlap on the blind side there and decide to go the open. They're screaming for it out the blind again. They've got an overlap here again. It's a double movement. It's held up. Good call by referee Guest there. Bark Alden player decided to crash through himself, but the Longreach players were up to the task and held him up, stopped him from getting the ball down. So we'll have a scrum pack 10 metres out, and Bark Alden will have the feed. They'll get another shot at it. Christy Blucher comes up with the ball. They go to blind this time. Out to Shorty Haywood. They come over with an easy try down the blind side. Well, probably three or four rucks ago, they could have done the same thing and got the try about 2 minutes ago, but they've gone a bit late, but they've still got the try. Well moved. Christy Blucher put the ball in the scrum, come up with a nice feed, and then unloaded down the blind side to Shorty Haywood. Bark Alden now lead 38 points to 12. A kick to come. Christy Blucher kicked off for Bark Alden not more than 5 minutes ago and kicked the ball clean over the top of the uprights. Paul Walsh off for Bark Alden being replaced. Replacements warming up on the line for Bark Alden. Number 15, Kevin Hitch. Number 17, Robert Tanner. Number 18, Labas Ciacia. So Coach Borlason deciding to go for his fresh reserves. About 18 minutes to go in this game. Christy Beach aligns the kick up. Looks all right. No, it's going to the right of the uprights.
Where the trophies, mate?
See on the table there? That little table with the red cloth? Well, a bad blue there from Longreach. They've kicked out on the full, so Bark Alden get a penalty restart halfway line. So still about 17 minutes in this game, so anything can happen as far as the scoreline goes. Christy Blucher goes for the big clearing kick, a beautiful kick from Christy Blucher. Advances the ball 20, 30 metres downfield, and Bark Alden get the tap about 30 metres out from the Longreach line. They set themselves for the play. Merv Cullen it is. Goes to Kevin Hitch. Hitch advances it into the defensive line. He's taken a nice tackle by the Longreach forwards. Ball comes out to Merv Cullen. Big strong run from Cullen. He dropped the ball though. He's lost the ball in the tackle. Longreach come up with the ball. 20 metres out from their own line. Settling ruck from the Longreach forwards. The front rower it is. Taking a nice tackle there by Craig Rogers. Well, some bit of catch-up football coming in here for Longreach. They're just unloading it anywhere. The referee's decided to pull it up. He's paying the knock-on. Very scrappy play there. Longreach could have settled it for another couple of rucks before they tried that sort of stuff. So the scrum will pack in about 20 metres out on the Longreach line, the far side of the field. Bark Alden with the feed. Christy Blucher puts the ball in. No, the referee calls it back. He wants the scrum to tidy a bit, get a bit tidier. Christy Blucher puts the ball in, comes out. Nathan Trag with the ball. Looking to break through, he makes through the first line of defence. Finally held by his opposite number. Right in front of the post they are, 15 metres out. Ball comes out to Craig Rogers, charging at the line. Pulls up 2 metres short. Bark Alden setting themselves down the blind side again. Aylett unloads to Cowan. Cowan running straight at the line, pulled up 1 metre short. Christy Blucher down the blind side, calling for the ball. Aylett shaping like he's going to pass it to him. Yes, he gets it out to Blucher. Blucher sidesteps, cuts back inside. Pulled up 1 metre from the line. Well, the ball goes right back to Nathan Tragg it is. The ball went right back there. They've lost about 10 metres in their play, Bark Alden. He's a fourth tackle, I think. Nigel Borlason with the ball. Charging at the line. Pulls up 3 metres short. Fifth and last signals the referee. Bark Alden try to barge over. Ball's come free. Longreach come up with it. And Longreach are held with the ball in goal. So it'll be a drop out from Longreach. Player down for Bark Alden, Nigel Borlason. Quite sure what's wrong with him there. Big fella slow getting back to his feet. Longreach with the restart underneath the goal post. Well, we believe that should have been a restart there, a handover. Peter Maloney it is with the ball. Trying to work out who these reserves are on the field for Bark Alden. As Peter Maloney took the ball up strong for Bark Alden. Scott Cowan it is with the ball now, taking 10 metres out from the try line on the far side of the field. Paulie Walsh unloads the big Merv Cullen. Cullen charging at the defensive line, carries the ball within 3 metres of the try line. Darren Hayward in attack, cuts it back into Rogers. Rogers advancing at the line, he pulls up a metre short. The backs are screaming for the ball out here, but the forwards keep cutting it inside. Let's see if Christy Blucher will call it this time. Replay it, he says, the referee. They tried to sneak in a little quick one. Now it comes out the back line, big long pass. Tanner it is, spills the ball. And Longreach come up with the ball. Number 15, taking a nice tackle there by Christy Blucher. Longreach half taken with the ball, unloads it though. They run down the far side of the field. The ball comes out there, spilt in the tackle. I think it's going to be a knock on both ways here. So a scrum will pack down 20 metres out from the Longreach try line on the far side of the field. Not quite sure who's got the feed here. Who's got the feed, Phil?
Barkey.
Barkey. Frank reckons Barkey will get the feed here. Yes, and he's right again. Christy Blucher it is, feeds the ball in. Ball's caught in the scrum there, but it comes out Bark Alden's way. Peter Maloney, it is, standing in at 5'8 for Bark Alden. Robert Tanner, it is, unloads. Hello, there's a fight broken out on the far side of the field. The linesman's come in. The boys are still playing football on this side. Broken up now. Broken up now. I don't think there's too much in it. The referee will probably say a couple of harsh words to the players and leave it at that. The touch judge is in. Touch judge Malcolm Wright reporting to the referee. The referee now calling out Nigel Borlason it is for Bark Alden and a number 16 for Longreach. The Longreach captain running over there just to find out what's going on. I don't think there was too much in that.
You see much in that? I wasn't watching the fight. I was watching the game.
Yeah, I don't think there's too much in it. Probably be a caution here and there'll be a play on, I'd say. See what referee guess says. Looks like he's running back to the 5 metre line. He's just going to have a play on. Okay, time on, says the referee. Ball comes out the Longreach line. Rucked up by number 14 for Longreach. 20 metres out, they're throwing the ball around. They're looking to set themselves out the back line. Oh, he's unloaded, stood and unloaded in the tackle. Hit by a strong line of Bark Alden defenders there. In Rogers, Maloney, Christy Blucher. Oh, and there's a big step from the body from the Longreach player. He stepped around two of the Barkey fellas and he's unloaded into the centre. Oh, and they've botched it up again. There was a try for the asking there for Longreach. They big centre it was, stepped inside the Bark Alden defence and when charging down the line, had two men to beat, stepped inside them. Being an unselfish type of player, he decided to unload it to his inside player who went about to spill it, so they've had a knock on when they could have got a try out of that one. Scrum packs down. Ball comes out to the Bark Alden back line, they're unloading it. Maloney out the hitch. Hitch looks to unload wide. Tanner it is. Knocks the ball on. I don't think he's taken a ball clean today so far. Just one scrum to another here at the moment. Very scrappy game. Bark Alden still leading 38 points to 12. The scrum's going to puck down 10 metres inside Bark Alden's territory and grandstand side of the field. Referee guess asked for the ball to be put back in again. Ball comes out Longreach way. Longreach halfback beats Christy Butcher in the tackle, but Nathan Schrag there to cover. Tackle one, says the referee. Longreach forwards calling for the ball. Dummy half goes with it, and he's taken 5 metres upfield. Ooh, looked like a knock-on there by the Longreach player in the play of the ball. Yes, and referee Gash was right onto that one. Calling the scrum, pack down, 20 metres inside Bark Alden territory. Bark Alden with the feed. Shit. Christy Blucher comes up with the ball, unloads to Nathan Tragg, trying to fend off the Longreach player. Peter Maloney in a dummy half. Unloads to Michael Aylett. Quacker Aylett is winding up the pace. Advances the ball up the cricket pitch. Good run by Aylett. He's busted through 3 or 4 tackles so far and advanced the ball 20 metres into the Longreach side of the field. Kevin Hitchett is with the ball. The ball went back behind him a bit. He had to check himself in that run. Trevor Haywood in a dummy half. Well, there's about 7 minutes left in this game. Christy Blucher goes for the chip kick straight into the Longreach player's hand, but he follows through on a beautiful tackle by Christy Blucher. And the Longreach player's going to stay down. Barely hit that Longreach player in a tackle. The chip kick followed it through and the Longreach player stayed on the ground. The first aid staff's been called on. A lot of concern being shown for this player. He hasn't moved since that tackle. At this stage, it looks like Bark Alden's going to be the first of the successful defenders for the Peter Blucher Memorial Shield. The score being 38-12. I can't see Longreach getting out of this one. Longreach player's okay again. He's back to his feet. Ready for the restart. Referee signals the restart. Oh, the Longreach player's lifted and driven in a big tackle by Nigel Borlison. Oh, he's a bit slow getting back to his feet as well. It's a big tackle there by Nigel Borlison. The Longreach forwards rucking it up through the middle of the pack. Taking in a nice tackle there by three of the Bark Alden defenders. Ball comes out the back line. They're going a bit one out at the moment, Longreach, and Bark Alden are finding it easy just to take them out of the play. Ball comes back out the Longreach back line. Now they're trying to set themselves for a move. They've got themselves in an overlap here. The Bark Alden wing is standing way back. He's on his own, but the cover defence has got across. He stepped around the winger and Labasse is here, but Labasse was able to grab his jersey and pull him down. Longreach go back to blind. Advance the ball another 5 metres downfield. The referee's picked something up in the play there. He blew his whistle. Called a scrum by the look of it. Referee signal timeout again.
Hey, Davey, you haven't been stopping the clock, have you?
No.
Yeah, don't worry about timeouts for reserve, guys.
Okay, well that Longreach player that's down was been down in play since Nigel Borlison hit him in a big tackle there before. Looks like he's okay now, he's back to his feet. Craig Rogers it is with to play the ball for Bark Alden. Labasse is here, takes it up. Beats the first tackle and's taken about 10 metres short of halfway. Back the ball goes to Scotty Cowan. Oh, he spilled it in the tackle. Longreach came up with the ball. CS here it is to take the tackle on the Longreach player, and Longreach finding it hard to advance their way through this Bark Alden pack. A couple of players limping out there for both sides at the moment. Out the back line it comes. Cut out pass to the Longreach forward, running wide. Oh, they've dropped the ball there. What's the referee going to do? He says, pick it up again and play it. Out it comes to blind side. Longreach player shapes for the kick, but he's held tackle there by Peter. Kevin Hitchett is and Peter Maloney. Out the blind side they come again. Nice tackle there from Bark Alden player. Number 17, Rob Tanner. Ball comes back out the Bark Alden back, the Longridge back line. Out the back line they come. The Longridge fellas put the chip kick in, or the downtown kick. Shorty Haywood, it is underneath it. He spilled it forward. Play on, says the referee. It was off his legs. The Longridge players come up with the ball. Let's see if they can get a try out of this one. Less than 5 minutes to go in this game. Longridge desperately want to try at this stage of the game, try and make the score more respectable. The Longridge player cuts back inside. Oh, they've got numbers all over the place here. And he's cut down there, a nice tackle by Nathan Schrag. Longridge desperately attacking the Bark Alden line. Looks like they may have come up with a try. The referee shapes. No, he's called double movement, I think. He's called held anyhow. We'll see what his ruling is. He's going to walk them back to 10 by the looks of it. And a pack of scrum. Held up over the line. Knock on. So Longridge will get the feed. No, he won't. Longridge are going to get the feed. Straighten the scrum up, says referee, yes. Longridge halfback puts the ball in, comes out. Now it does, and it screws the scrum, and Christy Blucher comes up with the ball. Well, that's a good win for Bark Alden. They should be able to tidy it up from here. Only about 3 minutes to go. Nathan Traggett is held with the ball. Tackle two for Bark Alden. Peter Maloney going in for a ruck there. Ball comes out to Christy Blucher for the clearing kick. Longridge winger comes up with the ball. Labasius is beaten in that tackle. Rob Tanner's been skirted. Longridge player going for the line. Who's the cover defender in there? Looks like Longridge could have got a try. The touch judge has agreed with it. Try to number 16, I think it was, for Longridge. 38-16 the score now with the kick to come. And I think the hooter will go before they finish the conversion here. Oh, if you stand a couple of metres back from it, mate. Just think of this. I'll screw that big lens off it for you. The score. Kick unsuccessful. Bark Alden walking back for the restart. They'll be lucky to get this kick in before the siren goes, I think. Christy Blucher restarts for Bark Alden and puts a deep kick into the Longridge end goal. Number 19 is for Longridge, takes the ball out, advances it up the 20-metre line, met in a big tackle by Merv Cullen, bounces off that tackle and keeps going, but then he's caught by Peter Maloney and Darren Haywood. Ball comes out, play on, says the referee. He's pulled it up for a knock-on. Well, I thought Darren Haywood picked that ball up okay there, but the referee, yes, saw it differently. He said, you pull the ball out of the player's arms there. You're not allowed to do that, so we'll give a penalty to Longridge on their 20-metre line. Longridge go for the quick tap. Peter Maloney walks up in the tackle. The Longridge halfback trying to step around the outside looking for support, but there's no one there. Christy Blucher comes up with the ball. Well, I'm sure he took the ball off him there in that tackle. Referee shaking his head. You pinch the ball from him, he said. We'll give another penalty to the Longreach players. And there's a siren. Longreach put in the final kick. Looks like the Bleacher Nathan Stragg, it is, spills it out that side of the field. Stragg cleans up. The Longreach players unable to recover the ball, so it'll be full time there. That's it, says the referee. Full time. Bark all and come up with the score. 38 points to 16 is the score. Proved themselves all year to be a hard side to toss. Longreach took it to them today, but congratulations to the Bark Alden team. Well done, fellas. Commiserations to the Longreach players. There'll be other games, and no doubt you'll get a challenge again next year. We've got Kerry Thompson here to present the shield for the inaugural Peter Blucher Shield. So if I can ask the captain of the Bark Alden side, Eddie Blucher, to come up. Christy Blucher, sorry. And we'll get Kerry to present the trophy. Well done, Chris. We'll just get a couple of photos while they're there. Well done.
Would you like to say a couple of words, Kerry?
I'll ask Kerry Thompson now to say a couple of words.
I'd just like to thank the Bark Alden Rugby League and Tom and Kay Mott for making this memorial possible. And it's a great honour to be able to present this trophy. Thank you.
Thanks, Kerry. Christy, would you like to say a couple of words on behalf of your team?
I'd just like to thank the Barkey boys. Had a good hard game. And the Longreach boys. Thanks.
Well done, Christy. Can I have the Longreach captain up, please? Speak on behalf of the Longreach side.
I'd just like to congratulate Barkey on a good hard game, and I'd just like to thank our followers for putting effort in. Thanks.
Well done, mate. Once again, congratulations to the Barkey side and the A-grade game.
Straight into this, huh? Well, welcome here to the Bark Alden Football Stadium and the main event of the day, Bark Alden versus Longreach. And a close encounter it should be. Both these teams have performed well in recent weeks. Bark Alden yet to be defeated. Well, the referee's very quickly called Albert's out here. Obviously, he didn't like the way he attacked ahead of the man in possession. It was Dave Bidoff. Lee Crane, the referee today. And he's having a few words there with the captain and Searles. And he's issued a penalty to Bark Alden. Very mobile, this Albert's. No, previous or former Capris player from Rockhampton, now residing in Longreach. We don't know for how long, but till the dogs start barking. But anyway, here we see this tap restart by Hayward. Back it comes to Dave Bidoff. He doesn't mind the damage just following. He comes at him again, makes 5 or 6 metres down the middle. Dummy half Hayward. He looks for Kerrigan there. The big fella cuts back inside, bounces it. 1 or 2, still going. Big Dave Kerrigan. Showing good form too this year, this fella. Very consistent forward. Back it comes from Hayward now. He looks for Danny Arthur and runs it wide of the ruck there. Just one off the edge of the ruck. And he's wrapped up good solid defence there for Longreach. Dummy half is Hayward. He gets the way to Liam Borson. Borson picks up young Arthur running wide. And gains 3 or 4 metres there. Crossfield there, straighten it up a bit. Across the open side they go again, Barkle. Out to Lyle Borson playing in 5-8 today. Tries to get round 1 or 2. Fifth and last is Cronin. What will Bark Alden put on here? Little halfback said, I'll kick it, and he kicks for touch. And finds touch about 10 or 15 metres out from the Longreach line. So Bark Alden on the attack here right from the start. Used that set of six pretty well. We'll see the first scrum to go down. And about 10 metres in from touch. We'll see the first scrum go down. Taken away, put in by Longreach and taken away by the little halfback in Darren Slade. And he gets it away. Gets a pass to the back and met a good Bark Alden defence and Goodger and Co there. Come away now, I can't pick this player for Longreach. He gains a few metres there, young Egan I think it might have been. Anyway, I can't pick him up back. Bark Alden hold him there deep in their own territory, Longreach. Trying to get out of it. Albert says, I'll get it to Searles. Searles will run a bit wide, he'll run all day. This fella will run wide. he's found a runner there, gets out of one or two and taken the ground by a good year underneath, finished off over the top by big Steve Crawley. Back it comes down to Searles. Searles cut back inside, bumps out of one or two. Keep going, he's through the middle there. He's lost the ball. Barkhorn will come up with it here through Lyle Balson. And takes it back over the halfway line towards halfway, and he gets over it. Then rake the ground there. Young Bubbles Bleacher, dummy half, gets it away to Liam Balson, picks up Harry Bleacher. The breaker, she says, come here down. They drive him to ground, number nine for Longreach. Oh, I've lost my paper, mate. What's happened to it? What happened to that bit of paper that was there, mate? Think of the team card. Anyway, we're back in here now. Barkhorn come away through. Haichi, young Haywood there, wrapped up about 20 metres out from the Longreach line. Just in from touch. Here, player back now. It comes to, here's the big fella there trying to pick up the lock forward. Is it Moose Matthews, is it? Rossi Matthews playing lock? Dummy half at Haywood. Fit the last, says Cronin. Gets it to the live balls and he said, oh, hoist it in the air. And it goes virtually nowhere, but straight up at Longreach underneath it. Come away with it. He's taking a good solid defence there. From Barkhorn, and namely Harry Bleacher and coat. And the Longreach player will go from dummy half. I can't pick that player up. A bit too far away on that end of the field. Their numbers are a bit hard to read in those blue jerseys too, Longreach. Anyway, that Longreach take it away to, out of their own 20-metre mark. Back it comes now, the big snotty, big Scotty Misley. Look at her, the big fella. She's burst up towards the halfway line. How long she'll last today? They've got about 20 minutes out of him last time here, but... And Searle says, give us it here and I'll root it downfield and bash for there. They call him minus $40 bashy. Had a good game in Blackall last week. He'll bring it back to him. Tries to get around one or two tackles and taken underneath the good tackle for Longreach. Hello, what's he real there? Well, he lost it in the tackle, did he? Now see a scrum go down. A little bad mistake there. The second scrum in the match here. Put in by Longreach. Take away by Skipper Slade, is it? Gets a pass back there. Picks up the fullback into the line. And well held underneath there by Matthews there. Back it comes to Longreach and he's died through. I can't pick that player for Longreach, but he scored under the post. The first try. First try to Longreach. First try to Longreach, right under the post. So early in the match there. With about 5 minutes gone. He's real time out there, but Longreach will attempt to kick. Some concern shown here for the injured player. Lyle Balson is, he's back on his pin. He's copped a little whack on the shoulder, has he? Big blow there, mate. No, he'd be right, mate. But you to get that magic sponge out. That mate. Yeah, and up go the flag. The Longreach lead 6 points to nil.
Well,
much improved side, this Longreach side this week apparently. Read each in the paper, that's all we got in the paper was Longreach. And what do you expect from the Longreach lead today? And that all resulted from a mistake 10 metres out from the Barkey line. But anyway, bash with the restart here. The fullback drives towards touchdown. It's going to go out in the full with a bad mistake. Well, two mistakes in a row here. See Longreach going the attack again here, right on halfway. The big crowd must be upsetting these fellas.
Work!
think it's going to make it, is it? Oh, yes, it's made it. Going to touch about...
Work! Turn around, book!
We'll see the tap restart. They look for a dummy runner and pick up Big Scotty Midley, and down the middle he comes, and Kerrigan and Co. wrap him up. He'll play it about 10 metres out. Longridge worked the open side through Slade. Gets away through the backs here. Cuts out one or two. Picks up a runner there. Where's this Aaron Moore, matey? Is it Aaron Moore? I reckon he loves the Richard Moore. Richard Moore. He didn't get the ball. He could get it this time. Here comes Searle. Searle's looking for a bit of a lap here. Picks up Moore, the try scorer. Goes for the corner. And he's got around him, has he?
Yeah,
no, he's gone into touch.
Yeah.
He's gone into touch. I don't want to get himself dirty, this fella. There's more. Don't like hitting the ground.
Good work, Moose.
Alias 007, Roger Moore. Bad luck, son. Anyway, she went to touch. Barkey to put in the scrum here. 007. Anyway, Bark will come away through. Little Liam Balsam. He takes a tackle there. Bash with a dummy half here. Oh, he's made a meal of it. He's in the horrors of Bashy. Back to first. Touch by Longridge. They work the open side. Oh, Longridge made a meal of it too. Oh, I see another scrum go down. Oh, they made amends for it, Barkey. They've got to have a scrum go down. About 80 metres out from their own line.
Keep working, Harry. Keep working.
There we see a scrum. Put in by Liam Balsam, taken away. He runs the blind side. Or the open side, I should say. And taken well by the Longridge defence. Gets it over the 20 metre mark. Back it comes to the young Danny Arthur down the middle. He goes. The Longridge defence is eager to take him on. About 30 metres out. Back it comes to the young Balsam looking for runners. And watch a bit off there. And he runs at Searle's. And Searle says, come here and down you go. It's been unusual to see Searle's in their tackling. She's usually hiding the backs. But anyway, back it comes to Kerrigan now. And the big fella goes down the sideline. And Dave Perry screaming there, the winger. But she couldn't get the ball. The big constable there on the wing. Back it comes to Balsam, who's back in the play now. Harry Blucher shows it one end, throws a pass out the big stick, Rolly. Oh, and he's gone without it. Oh, God, look at that. Harry not very impressed with that. We'll see another scrum go down. I think Barkle trying to push that pass a bit too fast there. Just settle it down for two or three rucks and let it go then. Let in, boy. Slade taken away. He picks up his fullback. Down the middle he comes, and he's wrapped that ball at all. About 30 metres out from the Barkey line. Now Barkey will have to defend here, the big fella. Big prop runs it down the middle there, and he knocked the ground. The number 8 for Longridge, I don't know his name, but anyway, we'll pick it up later. Back it comes, they work at the open side. On a good low tackle there. Harry Blucher, I might know, mate. He loves to tackle this fella. Anything low, mate, you can just be able to put his stamp on it. Back it comes to Slade, a bit of a juggle and a look then. Throws a stupid pass across field. Albert's picked it up, throws it to no one, it goes over the back. Still going, Longridge have it. Knocked back, he says, and he's real six to go. Hello, what's happened here? This is going forward, is it? A little knock on. We'll see a scrum go down.
Harry, get deep, Harry, get deep!
Barkle take it away through Liam Balsam. He works it through Lyle Balsam. He comes up there, tries to beat one or two, and gains a few metres. He'll get up and play it now. Back it comes to Liam Balsam there. He runs it on his own and said, I'll game myself. And they pick him up here and try to drive him back. A little half back there. He'll play it back now. It comes to the big fella and Rossi Matthews down the middle. He goes and they drive him to the ground right on halfway. Longish holding Barkle together here pretty well. They're trying to cut him apart, Barkle. Big Dave here, look out. He's seen an open, the big long copper. Here he goes. Batting in hand and ball under the arm. Well, he's chasing that blue Tirana around Barkhorn. Back it comes there. They work the oversight through. Bashford gets it through. They've got overlap here, Barkhorn. They've got Lawrence at 6 and 7. Oh, it goes at the back to young Bubbles. Blucher picks it up. Picks it back to his brother, Harry. He cuts back inside. Still going. He's about 20 metres out in the fifth tackle. And Blucher a dummy half here. He'll get it back to Liam Balsam and says, oh, put it up. A nice little kick over the top of this too, but it's going to go straight to the fullback. He'll bring it up towards the 20 metre mark. Getting good defence there for Barkholm and Matthews and Kay. And the big prop there drives it away there. And throw it to ground there. Good defence there by Goodger and Kay. And Rossi Matthews again it was. Big Snyder Midgley again. I'll go down the side here, the big fella. They throw down the ground there, the big fella. You got more bandages than Tullock, this fella. Back it come there. Bashford there, the fullback there. Takes it, no worries this time. Oh, and he slipped over and lost it again. Oh, and he's lost it too. Well, what a comedy here is there. Have a look at this. What's this bashy been on? Yippee beans or what? You want a quick charge of the mega, really? He's having a shocker. Hello, we bought the hooter. We know I heard the trumpet then, mate. Was that the trumpet?
Where's the boys with the big one? They still got it.
Anyway, Longridge come away through the open side of their backs they go. And Harry Bleacher in a good low tackle there, wraps up the Longridge fullback, I think it was. Way from dummy half, goes the hooker. He gains a few metres, in the centre I should say. He'll play it back now, comes across from Slade, looks for Searles, looks for a runner inside, looks outside, finds a big prop, gets it outside to Elvis. Elvis a quick hander, Moore pins the ears back. He's going for the corner, Moore, and he's going to score. Well, Longridge caught Bark all napping then. The easiest of tries, that one. All from a couple of mistakes with Bark all. Well, they're paying for mistakes. I don't know what's wrong with them. Anyway, Longridge have gone to 10 points to nil lead. In front of a fantastic crowd here. A lot of people back for the festival here. Big night in Barcorn last night. Some very heads getting around, still feel very, very blurry and weary. Anyway, a lot of capacity crowd there. They probably locked the gate. Jock probably shut them out. There's my co-commentator here, all the way from Rockhampton.
Eastlake.
What?
Eastlake.
Eastlake? Darryl Eastlake. All the way from Etna.
Yeah, but just to switch across here to the bad fellow and Cliff Bond. And we got Yeti here kicking here. And no good. And
10-0, mate.
10-0 to Longridge, and these lads want to pick their fucking. I'm sorry for swearing. Excuse me. I'm sorry for swearing that. 10-0 and Barkey won the pick, the act up. Oh, Bashy, he took off. He done the middle now. He didn't want to take the.
All right, she's lost it. She's lost the word. Now we see Barkle and resume there. Drive the ball down deep along the territory, and they bring it back through their front row.
Mate, have you got that team sheet there, Bert? Longridge?
Ask you for that long with sheep. And a big Selzy, the big yet goes down the middle. Dummy half. I think it's Slade as he gets it back and says rooted downfield. The Longridge player's offside. Young Ballard's offside there.
On Bashy. I'm
back. Back comes the Bashy. He runs up the middle. He comes up towards the 20 metre mark and takes the tackle. And a good tackle there. Get him onside. They're screaming out. Thanks, mate. Right. Now we'll see Barkey come away with it. Robbie Good just at all try and straighten the ruck and gets around one or two and driven to ground. He'll play it back there. Back it comes to the blind side there through the big fella and Dave. What's he reeled there? No, he's called someone out for a high shot. This old Yeti's at it again, mate. He slipped that old arm up at him. And Cronin says, just go and settle down, David. I've seen this. I'll see to it. And a penalty to Barkhorn. Well, what can Barkhorn put together here? I'm just trying to work that front row out. Robert Dickinoski it is for Longridge, number 8. And number 10 or 18 is Scott Risley. Righto, we've got him there. There's Hayward here, the tap restart. The fine touch around the halfway line through to Rossi Matthews, and down the middle he comes and gains a few metres there. And Albertson is wraps him up. Wire comes out, a big day bit off again down the middle. He loves his hard stuff. Those good hard yards he gains all the time. Hayward, a dummy arse, not going behind. A good scoot down the middle, this fella. We backed him in to score the first try in Alpha a couple of weeks ago. Picked up a handy old double. Back it comes the overside through Kerrigan. He runs over, tries to run over the top of the lock forward for Longridge and Ballard it is. Wire comes to Liam Balderson on the open side. He'll pick up Bash with the fullback, keen to get back in at young Bashy. Gets it inside the 20 on the fifth and last. Well, Bark won't have numbers wide here. They're looking for trying a few things here, trying to get through the ruck. Picked up by Balls and off the longest player. Has he scored, has he? I think he scored. Young halfback's gained the ball, the regain off the longest player, and he's gone in and scored. Tapped off the longest player, and I thought that was pretty fair too, there by Cronin. It was good work by the little halfback who nothing much was happening, and he took it on his own. So there we go, the two try scorers, the first point scorers, 7 and 7 in the double. Very, bit of a rarity that to happen in a game of football, but there it's happened there. So the kick to come, 10 points to 4, and Barker will hit back in the best way possible with a quick try. They badly wanted points here, the old co-commentator.
This is East Lake here. And they just scored a try there through little grubbers there through with Liam there. Taught him all I know.
Thanks, Clifford. Good to see you back for the festivities, mate. Enjoying the festivities? That's good, mate. You want to see, he's got titties lined up in front of his ear like a bloody knock 'em stall. I think he's been over and raided the knock 'em stall out of that sideshow here. Anyway, we see young Bubbles Bleacher to line this kick up. He practiced a bit of kick on this one. Yeah, he's a pretty smart individual work there by the little halfback. Up go the flags there, so the Bark all of a hit back well and truly. He's had 10 points to 6.
Lamb, keep working, keep organising.
80 minutes gone in this first half.
Keep going, brother, keep going.
On
the full, fellas,
on the full. Then we see Sales will restart here. Guys are downtown there. Comes a little halfback and goes over his head. Picked up by Basher there inside his own goal, and brings it back. He goes around Moore, skirts around him, but Moore can't tackle. But anyway, Basher gets it up towards the 20 metre mark and a good run. Yeah, he got a bit of spark up him, but anyway, he comes across to Kerrigan and there is sides a ruck up and slide sideways there, but big Scott Imagley and Co. and Sells and wrap him up. They'll work the open side. Back it comes to big Robert Goodger there, goes down. Gets away from one there, it's Ballard, it is. Slade, I should say. Wraps him up. Back it comes to Danny Arthur, running wide. Trying to skirt through the defence there, out wide. Can't get through the centre and Foley. Back it comes out to Ross Matthews, who straightens it down the middle, gets out of one tackle, flicks a pass out, the big Bullfather. He works the touchline. Big stick there, screaming for it, fifth and last, says Cronin. Looking back all and put on here. Gets it back to Bash with the fullback and says, we'll drive it downtown, a good kick. Roberts it is it, runs across there and picks it up nicely. He comes up towards the little halfback, gets past him, but Harry Blucher won't miss him, and underneath he goes. And a good tackle. Longwich worker through... I can't pick that player up. I think he's a Wayne Ballard, I think it was. He took the ruck up there. Back it comes down to big Scotty Mizzy, and they said, come here, and they drive in the ground, the big fella. And Robert Goodger, and finished off by Kerrigan. Well, they keep the big fella running for 80 minutes, so I'll be real surprised. Wade goes to Sales and says, we'll drive it downtown. We don't want to play it here. And drives it, let's go dead. And it's gone dead, too deep. That was the,
keep them working, Bashy. Keep them working.
Barkle to resume with a free kick here. As we just see the old CHW? Clem Wilson. Vaughan's plane just flies in over the top of us. And away, back to the play anyway. It comes away to Big Dave. Bit off down the middle he goes. Gains a few more metres. Taken well by Midgley and K. Back it comes to the open side. Big Kerrigan out wide there, runs across and Alberts goes low and then drives into ground. He'll play it back. Wade goes across the open side to Lyle Wilson, picks up Harry Bleach on the run. Harry tries to get round one or two there. And he's set upon by Moore and they lift him up. Dick and Oski was to give him some assistance. Back it comes the little halfback. Tries to get around one or two. Gains a few metres. Wade comes out fifth and last, says, referee craning him down, it goes to Moore, to Robert. He brings it back towards the halfway line. He's caught about 20 metres inside Longwich territory. Back it comes now, I can't pick this back up, I think it's a winger from the other side. Number 5, is it? Jared Moore, the other winger. You know, work at the blind side, still through the big Yeti, the big fellas, they said, come here. And they